Yeah, you know what? I figured I'd give it a shot. Again, I fly a lot of questionable IFR. Well, I fly a lot of IFR and questionable aircraft. In other words, they don't have the... They have avionics, but not good ones. And it was, it's some pretty bad stuff. And,
well, now it's time to do
more of that. Because this shows, it shows radar and everything. It's absolutely... Yeah, and it, it, basically it's a guy who makes these units. And you pay $200 for something like this. Versus $1,100 for the Stratus, which is really a good unit. But extremely expensive. Or a Seaville 39. I figured I'd give this a shot. And so far, so good. You ordered the parts, you're gonna build it.
Yeah,
I'm gonna build it myself. Came out the 115.
Oh, nice.
I'm building this one.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Now, is that the, because I know they have one with a clear case, I saw that.
No, it's a white case. It's got the antenna system, the same thing as that. I already have the battery. The battery pack. So I
didn't really this was like the whole kit.
Yeah.
The whole the case and everything. I figured, ah, you know what? If I wanted to do, I wanted to build it too. I wish I had. I never had time for it.
I love the videos. And what's going to do.
It's real
minutes.
Simple.
Yeah, about 10 minutes to do it.
Yeah, it seems real simple. I just thought, you know what, for this, I can have a number, you know? Yeah, we'll see how that works. Yeah, Strata. They got a good deal on their website right now. Would you go right to their website?
For what, Stratus?
Yeah, for the Stratus.
I've got the list off them. I saw what they were charging. Then I went on eBay.
And compared to Walmart that way,
compared to prices, and the prices were better on eBay.
Yeah, of course.
With a make sure they were all local to somebody close by.
I mean, what do you really need? You need the board.
Right.
You need the case.
Uh-huh.
You need the antennas.
Now, to be on the safe side, I got the external GPS.
Yeah.
Even though it's GPS on the iPad.
Yep.
I figured.
Same thing, I have the external GPS in it.
Well, I have the external. And,
Is there like an AHARS chip? Is that what they do on that?
Okay, I didn't get the AHARS. I saw that after I got ordered everything. I saw the AHARS. I should have gotten that too.
Yeah.
That's about $15.
And I don't know if it's really, I don't think it's necessary. But I guess it's, I don't know, it was kind of like an extra thing. You know?
If I had an experimental, then I put it up because I didn't have my iPad in the plane.
Right.
I depend on, well, not depend on, but that would be a backup.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
tighter and that wheel still shakes like
how about your flight instruments themselves? You want to double check everything if I do see some issues. So start with airspeed. The altimeter's set. So what was the altimeter setting from the 3006? What's the field elevation here? Do you remember? 85 feet, right? So we have a maximum we can be off 75, but I always like to look if it's more than like 40 feet. 40 feet, start to look and see why that is. And a lot of times it's just because there's mechanical delay too. So as long as you're comfortable there, because the field does change, and where that 85 feet is going to be the highest point, runway portion. So that may not even apply out here. We can already see there's a slope down, so that looks pretty good. Vertical speed looks good. Our head. Then the other thing I like to do is when it says radios, when you're doing the whole setup, it says common nav setup. Well, we know we're using navigation today, so we need to break our map out. We need to look at what those navigation points are.
So you're setting real
that's correct. Yeah, best to set it on the ground. So we put the frequencies that we need in there and the heading that we generally think things are going to be. Basically, just like the radio, except it's a nav portion.
With this,
that's correct.
Set this one at the CR?
I would set, yeah, because it looks like 115.2 you have here, then 114.8 is already behind it.
Oh, okay.
And so you got 114.8 up here also. So let's come up with a general heading, though. We said earlier that just to fly from here to Cedar Lake was a northeast heading. So if we're going to assume this is radio 1, that's head 1, and we're on nav, that means we're on the VOR. So now we have to tune the VOR using the OBS in the general direction that we're going to go.
It was northeast.
So I don't know, pick a heading, 03, 05, something like that. Because it's generally the direction that we're going to go in order to get to. That's all right, we can, you know, move on from there. So, and then from Cedar Lake out to Sea Isle, we're looking at generally a southern heading. So we can set south with the second
field.
Yeah, just set it right at 180. And then we'll figure that out when we're up there with one little better gas. Center the needle by turning the OBS in order to center it, and then that'll give us our heading up there.
So if we get up to about 1,000 feet.
Well, yeah, and it depends too, because there's not all the radios can be grabbed from every direction, every distance, and every altitude. So there, in the airport facility directory, it tells you that information. But we're just going to simply climb out. Once we get our two flag, we'll know we have a pretty good lock on it, and then we'll identify it, make sure we know, and then track it from there.
Millville Project, Skyhawk, Rock, Sierra, and 32, Millville Project.
Now those guys took off out of here, they're doing 160 knots all the time. Imagine it's going to be a little gusty on takeoff. Remember, use your rudders to keep that control. And the winds are going to be on our right side a little bit.
not great, but it's good. So we have to start outside of the wall and pick something. Okay. First thing I gotta do is keep my wind level. So chip back over and doesn't cover. I have to pick an attitude. I think it's good to try it. But if I can't accomplish that, then yes, I do have to be powerful. Like I mentioned, it's power. It just means to do that. For around the 500%, for 100 knots, I'm looking for my heading. So we have to start something to drive the wings left, and then hit at this. You shouldn't have any rudder at all. Because the nose is down, it's tapering at right side edge. Which I have a bit of a problem that I think is bringing the problem down here. Motor, I'm going to slightly direct it in a different direction. Hold that ball directly down. And there's not the bus that passes the dump, so it's just a little correction from there. And good. Good. Now if I said, okay, can we find 5 knots? Yeah, we could pitch, but we wouldn't descend at all. So I have to bring back that power from about 1800. I'm just going to start with power. Hold my nose in place and see if that works. I have to trim, but I want to get all that pressure out, but I'm going to fight it. So my nose is not going down here. So pitches here. Also, what am I trying to accomplish? Well, I'm not giving any specifics on what you said. It's just a matter of maintaining that concept. Start from square one, 11. Just pick up horizon. Try it. But again, it's not working. I got to pick my foot down. Now, if I want a punch victory, I'll leave my power alone. Start to try from the outside. Try that. We'll go. So they get up on top. It's not going down. So pitches for the airspeed powers. Out for altitude. Airspeed, that's always the constant. Now while we're descending and holding 95, let's make a turn to a heading what's going on? Yeehaw! sit around, but we can still come up for me. Where's the horizon? What's the power set in here? And what will we go to 25? Level off about here. It's straight ahead. It's an hour, right? Always power. Power first. See that? The second level. Power. ball change. It's a level horizon, so we're just kind of down to the right around there. So you want to start. And the nose is still going down, so you've got to stop. again, it's not going to be consistent because today is fucking. That's me putting that turn in. And if you want to get that turn in and get it in, hold it in. Get it across with the direction or a wind direction. I don't know, I think you conjure these days up on purpose. I am really trying to figure out this fuel situation. Do you see what's going on here?
We didn't use that
one. No, I know, but it's really, really wacky. Better off having a humongous battery on this thing. Power the whole airplane.
Yeah. My battery pack is pretty big.
Yeah? Oh, we're going to compare battery packs now, huh? No, that's good. This is, they said it with a relative, I mean, it's only a 6,000 milliamp, whereas I carry a 10,000 to charge my phone and all that kind of stuff. I could also try that one. What's nice about the one that they send with it, it's got its own little built-in plug. So you just pop it out and plug it right into the side of the wheel. I'll tell you what, these suction cups, they're really decent. I'm surprised. I always get buyer's remorse though, like I feel I don't deserve this kind of stuff. Did you see how the wire comes right out of this?
Yeah.
So it's kind of convenient. Kind of. That is very good. Yeah, park right next to old lollipop there. They seem like they're back pretty quick. They left before we did.
Yep.
I wonder if that was a recast. I think so. It's an absolute struggle. It's a fight. If they weren't beneficial, I would. So, but there will be days that I'm going to say to you, hey, look, you just can't do this today because it's not conditioned.
Yeah.
And we're actually starting to come up on that too, because my focus is going more towards the takeoff and landing. That's where I want to be, and that's where you're progressing towards. So, I'm sorry, you can get it shut down so I'm not going to burn hops on. Yeah, because of that wind, huh?
Okay.
I'm gonna hop up there. I want to look in.
Okay.
I want to see if it is that much or what the case is. Because that's huge.
Yeah.
And we're running a high RPM. It's 13.4. We're definitely running a high RPM, which is going to consume much more fuel, but not to that extent. I mean, maybe 10 gallons. Yeah, it's a huge difference. There's definitely only around 10 gallons in this tank.
And this is almost full?
It's like almost full, yeah.
So it drew all off the left, and she was on both.
Yeah, it was on both. I just did that to hold it, because otherwise it'll level out, and I want the mechanic to look at it.
Yeah.